Good morning, students. So we are discussing trigonometry chapter, right?
Yes.
So what we learned in the trigonometry,
trigonometric ratios,
then relationship between the trigonometric ratios, trigonometric values for the specific angles like 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90 degree. Then using that values, how to solve the problem. Then trigonometric ratios of complementary angles. Okay, in the last class, while finishing the chapter, so that last class, we'll again see that all. Okay, I'll share the pages, whatever we discussed from the beginning class. Okay, that we will revise once while finishing the class. Okay, but for the last class, we need again this class and tomorrow's class and day after tomorrow's class. I need two more periods. Okay, so because the last exercise little bit heavy. Last exercise is little bit heavy. Okay. So today we are going to start. So the trigonometric identities. So trigonometric identities. First, let us discuss what is that identities. You all know that algebraic identities, right? Identities, when we can use that word identities, it is true for all the values. Not only 0, okay, if we took 0, then this identity matches. If we took 1, this identity does not match us. So we don't want that type of condition, okay? Identity in the sense it must be matched. Or it is true for all the values of the variable. If I took algebraic identities, it must be true for all the values of variables. When it comes to trigonometric identities, this identities must it should true for all the values of that angles. Is that clear? Okay, for all the values, it must be true. Then only it is called as trigonometric identities. Here we use the trigonometric relationships. Okay, for the identities, we use the trigonometric relationships. Okay, so here we have three identities, trigonometric identities. So using that three trigonometric identities, we have to deal with many problems. So, what is that three trigonometric identities? First, we'll look at that one. Okay, then we'll work out the problems related to that trigonometric identities. Okay, so first, again, today also, for the trigonometric identities, we are going to take the help of right angle triangle only. So, now you just take, what is visible, my students? Yes, let us take one right angle triangle ABC. Okay, take the right angle triangle ABC and right angle at angle B. Okay, now mark this angle A as theta. Mark this angle A as theta, or you can take C also. Is that clear? Any one angle you have to mark. And then if this is the marked angle, then what happens actually, this BC is opposite side, then this line, perpendicular line, P, perpendicular line is act like a adjacent side and this one is hypotenuse. So you can take opposite side for this as base also, because your opposite side is base of the triangle. Then adjacent side is perpendicular of the triangle. Hypotenuse is always hypotenuse only. Is that clear, students? This is about the right angle triangle. So now we all know the Pythagoras theorem. In any right angle triangle, square on the hypotenuse, which is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. Okay. So now let us apply the Pythagoras theorem. So AC square, which is equal to AB square plus BC square. We'll start the identity derivation. Here we are deriving the identities. Okay. So how this comes actually, that we have to see. So first identity, we are glancing the first identity. So for that first identity is identity. I took the right angle triangle and then I applied that Pythagoras theorem in any right angle triangle. So in a triangle ABC, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Okay, now what we have to do is, for all, both LHS and RHS, we have to divide, okay? Let us call this equation as equation number 1. And now what we have to do is, for the equation number 1, so we have to divide the equation 1 by AC square. So what we have to do, we have to divide the equation 1 by AC square. Then AC square, okay? AC square divided by AC square. Second step, I'm showing second step. Divide the whole equation by AC square. So AC square by AC square, which is equal to AB square by AC square plus BC square by AC square, okay? AC square. What we did actually second step. So for the first equation, so divided by AC square. So are you observing AC square, AC square, AC square. Now, AC square by AC square, what is the result actually? 1. AC square by AC square is equal to 1. Now, AB square by AC square. Just observe the diagram, students. AB is this one. AB square by AC square. That is adjacent by hypotenuse square. Adjacent by hypotenuse in the sense which relation? Adjacent by hypotenuse. Yes, yes. Cos square, no? So what is that one? Cos square. Cos square A. Can we take that one? Because we are taking angle A as reference angle. So AB square by AC square. AB square by AC square. AB by AC is the function of cos for angle A. Because AB is adjacent side, the AC is hypotenuse. Adjacent by hypotenuse is cos, cos function. Therefore, this is cos square A. Okay, cos square A plus BC by AC. Now, BC is opposite, opposite side here. Then AC is hypotenuse. BC by AC, opposite by hypotenuse is a ratio of sine, no? Yes, sine function. So therefore, sine square A. Got the idea of this one? Yes. So this is the first identity. 1 is equal to cos square A plus sine square A. So if we arrange this in the proper way, sine square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. So this is the first identity, sine square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. Or you can take, here we used A as a reference angle, no? So that's why we are taking sine square A plus cos square A. You can take sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. This is the standard formula. Always. So, you have to use sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Theta will be decided by you. Okay, so theta, if we took theta as angle A, then sine square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. Or if we choose C as the marked angle, then sine square C plus cos square C is equal to 1. So, whenever using the formula, so standard form is sine square theta plus cos square theta, which is equal to 1. How you got the relationship? Very easy, no, students? First, we have to apply the Pythagoras theorem concept. Then for that Pythagoras theorem statement, so whole equation you have to divide it by AC square. Then AC square by AC square is 1. Here, AB by AC, just observe the relation in figure. AB by AC is adjacent by hypotenuse whole square. Adjacent by hypotenuse is cos. Then cos whole square. Cos whole square in the sense cos square A. Cos A whole square is nothing but cos square A. Is that clear, students? Yes. See, sin A whole square. In the sense, what it indicates actually? Sin square A. Is that clear? Sin A whole square in the sense, sin square A. So, here we got the relationship that AB by AC is adjacent by hypotenuse, that is cos. That is why here square is there, no? That's why cos square A. Plus, BC by AC, so that is opposite by hypotenuse, sine square A. So here we got the relationship that sine square theta plus cos square theta, which is equal to 1. Sine square theta plus cos square theta, which is equal to 1. Is that clear? This is the first identity. Now let us work out the second identity. I'll take the same expression. Can I rub this one? Yes. Let us erase the first identity blue. But I'll take this one as it is. we are going to keep that first statement equation as it is for the next two derivation also. Now, for the second identity, see here in the triangle ABC. So, Pythagoras theorem, according to Pythagoras theorem, square on the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. Got the idea of this now? In the first identity, what we did actually? Whole equation is divided by AC square. Now, the whole equation is divided by AB square. Okay, another side AB. Now, we are concentrating on AB square. In the first derivation, so we divided the whole equation by AC square. Now, divide the whole equation by AB square. What will get to be? AC square by AB square, which is equal to AB square by AB square plus BC square by AB square. Is that clear, students? What we did actually? Divide the whole equation, equation number 1 by AB square. Now we have to observe. AC by AB, just observe the figure. AC is hypotenuse divided by AB is adjacent. Okay, now if you want clarification, we'll write like this. Hypotenuse divided by adjacent whole square. Okay, hypotenuse divided by adjacent whole square. Then AB by AB is 1 plus BC by AB. BC is opposite divided by AB is adjacent. Opposite by adjacent whole square. So now, hypotenuse by adjacent, which ratio? Hypotenuse by adjacent. Yes, sec theta. Okay, secant whole square. Here we are using angle A as reference angle. No? So, sec K whole square in the sense sec square A. Can I write the answer directly? Sec square A, secant square A, which is equal to 1 plus opposite by adjacent. Which function? Opposite by adjacent. Yes, tan. Very good. Tan square A. Is that clear, students? So, sec square A is equal to 1 plus tan square A. Or you can write this as 1 plus tan square A is equal to sec square A. Like a change manual. Okay. So, or you can take 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. Is that clear, students? So, this is about the second one. 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. Is that clear? 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. Or you can modify this one as, see here, 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. Actually, this is a standard form. In some problem, we have to substitute the tan value. Then how can you change? Tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. Then minus 1 also you can use. Then, if you want one place, so then tan problem is there. 1 is equal to sec square theta minus tan square theta. So, whenever if you got the condition that secant square theta minus tan square theta, in that type of situation, you can substitute 1 because you are having this identity. Got the idea of this one now? 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. If you fix that 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta, then remaining work and all on spot in the answer paper, you can do that one now while solving the problem. Yes, this is about the second identity. Now, can we discuss the third identity now? Yes. Again, same. Third identity. So, here we will work out the third identity now. Same procedure. AC square is equal to, in triangle ABC, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So here, what we did actually, whole equation is divided by AB square. Now what is the remaining side? In the first step, we used AC. In the second derivation, we used AB. What is the remaining side? BC. Now we have to do. So whole equation 1, we have to divide by BC square. Whole equation we have to divide by BC square. Now, AC square by BC square is equal to AB square by BC square plus BC square by BC square. Is that clear? This is the first step. Now, AC by BC. AC is hypotenuse divided by BC is opposite whole square, which is equal to AB by ABC adjacent by opposite, okay, whole square plus BC square by BC square is 1. Now, our hypotenuse by opposite is which function? Hypotenuse by opposite, cosec function, right? Now, hypotenuse by opposite is cosec, that is cosec square A, which is equal to adjacent by opposite is cot square A plus 1. This is the third identity. Cosec square A is equal to cot square A plus 1. Or you can write this as cot square A plus 1, which is equal to cosec square A, or cot square theta plus 1, which is equal to cosec square theta. Is that clear, students? This is about the third identity. Third identity. Is that clear? All the identities, first, second, third. First one is sin square theta plus cos square theta, which is equal to 1. Second one is 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. And third one is cot square theta plus 1 is equal to cosec square theta. See here, cot square theta plus 1, which is equal to cosec square theta. If you want to change in terms of cot, then cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta minus 1. If in the problem you are facing cosec square theta minus 1, then you can substitute as cot square theta. What the idea? R cosec square theta minus cot square theta. 1 is equal to cosec square theta minus cot square theta. Then you can substitute the value as 1. But you have to see the problem, whether it is necessary or not for the proof. So, you have to apply these three identities. So, this is about the first identity, second identity and third identity. Now, I want to tell one more type of formula derivation. Okay, so we got the idea of three identities, right? So, anyhow, first identity is same only. First identity, what is that first identity? Is sine square theta plus cos square theta, which is equal to 1. Sin square theta plus cos square theta, which is equal to 1. So, this is the first identity. So, I need the second or third identity, no? Then what we have to do, whole equation, consider this as equation number 1. With the help of first identity, we can derive the second and third. Okay, we can give the connection for the derivation first, second and third. Now, if we divide the whole equation by cos square theta, then we'll get one identity. Let us try that one. So, whole equation is divided by cos square theta. Let us observe. Now, sin square theta by cos square theta plus cos square theta by cos square theta is equal to 1 by cos square theta. So, we are deriving the second identity with the help of the first identity. What we have to do? For the first identity, we have to divide by cos square theta. Then, sin square theta by cos square theta. What is the relationship? Sin by cos, tan. So, we can write sin square theta by cos square theta as tan square theta plus cos square theta by cos square theta is equal to 1. Then, 1 by cos square theta. 1 by cos, yes, 1 by cos is a, yes, secant square theta. 1 by cos is a reciprocal of secant theta, yes, secant square theta. Got the idea of this one now? We got the second one, right? Yes, we got the second one with the help of first identity. Now, with the help of first identity, we'll derive the third identity now. So, there, divided by cos square, no? Now, we have to divide it by sin square theta. Now, divide it by sin square theta. To get the third identity with the help of first identity, we have to divide the first identity, full identity by sin square theta. Now, we just observe sin square theta by sin square theta plus cos square theta by sin square theta. Okay, which is equal to 1 by sin square theta. Got the idea of the one first step? Now, sin square theta by sin square theta is 1 plus cos square theta by sin square theta. What is the relationship? Cot. Yes, cot is equal to cos by sin. So, cot square theta, which is equal to 1 by sin is cosec. Very good. Cosec square theta. Got the idea of the third identity? Yes, third identity is 1 plus cot square theta is cosec square theta, no? Or cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. Got the idea of these three identities? Yes, these identities are true for all the values. So that's why this is called as trigonometric identities. Now, with the help of these identities, we have to work out the problems. Can we solve the problems now? Yes.
Board is dirty now, so nothing to do for that.
Cloth is there. Give that one. 1 second. Yes. See, we have got the idea of three identities. First, we'll write the three identities once. Sin square theta plus cos square theta, which is equal to 1. Second one, 1 plus tan square theta, which is equal to what? 1 plus tan square theta, which is equal to secant square theta. Okay, third one. So then third one is 1 plus cot square theta, which is equal to cosec square theta, right now? Yes, right now, three identities. 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. So these are the three identities. Using these three identities, we have to work out the problem. Is that clear? Okay. So let us see the example first problem. Example 12. In your textbook, it is example 12. But this is first example for this topic, trigonometric identities. Express the ratios cos A, tan A and secant A in terms of sin A. So we're trying to understand the problem. We have to express the ratios of cos A, tan A and secant A. Okay, see your first example problem. Cos A, tan A and secant A. We have to express these ratios in terms of sin A. In the sense, so when we express this, when we convert this one, so we need the answer as sin form. The answer must be in the sin form. So that is a sin expression. Is that clear? So we have to write cos A in terms of sin, tan A in terms of sin and secant A in terms of sin. Okay, first we'll take the help for this. Which identity is going to help? Which identity we can take? First one, identity 1, cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. So with the help of that one, we can convert cos in terms of sin. Then we'll see the secant and tan. Later we'll discuss that secant and tan. So for that, I'm going to take the help of sin square theta plus cos square theta, which is equal to 1. Okay, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Here they have asked cos A, tan A and secant A. So that's why, so in place of theta, sin square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. Let us take sin square A plus cos square A plus 1. Now we have to express this cos A in terms of sin A. Now let us write first cos square A. So what happened? Cos square A, which is equal to 1 minus sin square A. Is that clear, students? Yes, cos square A is equal to 1 minus sin square A. Yes, cos square A in terms of sin albantalva. Yes, now we need cos A. So what is the result of cos A? Cos A is equal to plus or minus square root of 1 minus sin square A. Is that clear, students? Cos A is equal to plus or minus square root of 1 minus sin square A. So, cos A. So, let us choose the positive value cos A, which is equal to plus root of 1 minus sin square A. This is the conversion of cos A in terms of sin. This one is answer. So, this is the expression of cos A in terms of sin. See here why we choose sin plus only. Here plus or minus. Whenever putting the square sign, so we are taking plus or minus. So here So we are using only 0 to 90 angles, no? Specific angles in the sense 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90 degree. That 0 to 90 angles always in the positive axis, in the first quadrant only. So that's why we are taking the positive sign value only. Cos A, which is equal to square root of 1 minus sin square A. Okay, cos A is equal to square root of 1 minus sin square A. Now, with the help of this cos A, can we try to write tan A? Now, cos A function is over. Cos A, we expressed in terms of sine function. Clear now? Only sine function, 1 minus sin square A. Now, we have to write tan A in terms of sine function. Tan A. Now, it's time to write tan A. How can we write tan A, students? Can you give the hint? Tan A. Only sine function we need in the answer side. How can we convert that tan into sine? Tan A. First, tan theta in the sense. Yes, tan A sine by cos. Very good, Rashmi. Tan A in the sense sine A divided by cos A. Right now, sine A divided by cos A. Yes, very good. Sine by cos. Pannaga, very good. Tan A in the sense sine A by cos A. Now, tan A which is equal to sin A will keep sin A only divided by cos A. Just now we got the answer cos A is equal to square root of 1 minus sin square A. Can I substitute cos A as square root of 1 minus sin square A? Yes, cos A is equal to square root of 1 minus sin square A. So, is that clear, students? This is the, yes, sine. Are you observing the sine function? Yes, tan A is converted into sine function. Is that clear? This is about tan A. Next, we'll see the secant A. Now, we have to express secant A in terms of sine. How can we write secant A? Yes, secant A. What is the trick? Sine barbeck. In the RHS part, we need secant A is equal to sine in term. Yes, secant is 1 by cos. Very good, Panaga. Yes, secant A, we can write it as 1 by cos A. Secant A, we can take, yes, very good. All are sending the answers. Secant A, which is equal to 1 by cos A. That is equal to 1 divided by cos A answer. Just now we got, that is, square root of 1 minus sine square. Yay, yes, simple. This is the end of the problem. You just observe. So, cos A, we expressed in terms of sine. Then tan A, we expressed in terms of sine. Then secant A, we expressed in terms of sine. This is the very important question, students. Okay, got the idea of this problem? Do you have any problem in this problem? Yes, if you are having any confusion and all, so then we'll discuss. Yes. Mataji, can we use second identity? So if it is possible, you can use Rashmi. Second identity help in the name of sine function. So you have to think whether if we use second identity, can we come to sine function? Then you can use any identity. This is not restricted that first identity only we have to use. So we have to think whether 1 plus tan square A is equal to sec square A. Can we convert it into sine square function? You can try that one. Okay. You just try to work out how to express the tan A, cos A and secant A in terms of sine with the help of second identity. Okay. Yes. So got the idea of this one, no? First problem, no? With the help of first identity, it is very easy actually. Is that clear? Okay, so can we go to the next question now? Yes, next. See, all the problems are really different problems. So let us see the second question. Second problem. Second question is like this. Prove that secant A of 1 minus sin A into secant A plus tan A, then which is equal to 1. So we have to prove that. So what we have to prove here? Secant A, second question, secant A into 1 minus sin A, okay, into secant A plus tan A. So this expression after simplification, the answer must be equal to 1, we have to show. So that is our target. When we simplify this LHS part, so it must be equal to 1 because in the RHS 1 means there. Show that. So how many, did you got the idea of this problem, students? How many of you got the idea? What trick we have to apply here? We have to start the problem with LHS part, right? Okay, let us start the problem with LHS. LHS is equal to secant A into 1 minus sin A into secant A plus tan A. So we have to start the problem with LHS part. Now, what is the first step, students? What we have to do here? What we have to do? Get 1. Our target is to reach 1. So we have to simplify this LHS part. Okay, so answer is 1. Yes. Cos A is equal to 1 by cos A is equal to secant A. Yes, very good. Someone is telling the answer that secant A, okay, we can write it as 1 by cos A. Yes, secant A we can take as 1 by cos A. Then 1 minus sin A, so we will keep 1 minus sin A, 1 minus sin A only. Now again, secant A, can I write secant A as 1 by cos A plus tan A? Tan A, sin by cos, can I write sin A by cos A? Yes, sin A by cos A. This is the first step, students. Yes, sin by cos. See here, what we did actually, secant A, we took this as 1 by cos A, then 1 minus sin A, 1 minus sin A as it is, then secant A again 1 by cos A, plus sin A is sin A by cos A. What is the next step, students? So next step is here. 1 into 1 minus sin A is 1 minus sin A divided by cos A. Okay. So into 1 by cos A plus sin A by cos A. Sin A by cos A. So now in the next step, what we can do actually, 1 minus sin A will keep 1 minus sin A only, divided by cos A. Okay, this bracket is as it is. Here in this bracket, by taking, see here, cos A, cos A, same denominator. So then what we can write? Cos A. So in the numerator, 1 plus sin A. 1 plus sin A. Got the idea of this step, no, student? Cos A, same denominator. If the same denominator is there, then we have to add the numerator. So in that step, 1 minus sin A by cos A into 1 plus sin A by cos A. Now what we have to do? We have to do the multiplication. Numerator into numerator multiplication, denominator into denominator multiplication. Okay. 1 minus sin A into 1 plus sin A. There you can observe the identity, A minus B into A plus B, that is A square minus B square. According to that condition, 1 square minus sin square A. Are you observing that one? 1 square minus sin square A divided by, okay, divided by here. So we have to write the equal sign, no? Divided by cos A into cos A, cos square A. Cos square A. Now, 1 square is 1 only, no? Minus sin square A. Which topic we have to apply here? Which concept we have to take here? So we have to take sin square A plus cos square A is equal to 1 topic. Sin square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. But here 1 minus sin square A is there. Then cos square A is equal to 1 minus sin square A. So we are using this condition. You know, 1 minus sin square A is nothing but cos square A. Now substitute 1 minus sin square A as cos square A divided by cos square a get cancelled. Answer is 1. Got the idea of this problem, students? See, actually, we can avoid 2 steps actually. Here only. So, illa e step alle e simplification al ban bidbekitt actually. Ban bittidre we can escape that step na actually. So, 1 step we can remove. Got the idea of this problem, the students? See here, for secant a we have to write as 1 by cos a. Then, 1 minus sin a as it is. Then, again, secant a 1 by cos a. Tan a sin a by cos a. See here. So, in this section actually, in the last trigonometric identities problems, we are going to use all what we learned from the beginning classes. So, we are using that relationship actually, relationship between the trigonometric ratios and ratios we are using here, okay. So, and last we are using the trigonometric identities also. So, now here after the simplification, 1 into 1 minus sin a is 1 minus sin a divided by cos a, here 1 plus cos a plus sin a by cos a. Then here just adding this portion we have to simplify. Then numerator into numerator, denominator into denominator, then you will get the clear picture of this problem. Is that clear, students? This is about the second example problem. So, I got the warning that only 5 minutes remaining, okay. So, let us do one thing. Let us end this meeting. Join with the same link. Just we'll discuss the 2 more problems. Then we'll end the class. Is that clear? Okay. So, now I'm going to end this meeting. Join with the same link. 42 strength. Okay, so I need the same 42 strength. Okay.